Everybody, this is Bo back in the Sports Lounge. We want to do a shout-out to the 1.5 million listeners we have all over this world and the military bases that make that happen. Thank you for the email and text. Right now, we're going to go to Sioux Falls and get a chance to talk a little football with head football coach Kalen DeBoer. Sir, how you doing?
I'm great. It sounds like you're doing okay.
Yeah, well, you know, when it comes with that, we get a lot of emails, a lot of text, and at times it's almost overwhelming to reply back to everybody. And one of the big questions was, is why don't you have more national championship winners on? And we're like, okay, we're going to go after Coach DeBoer.
Well, I appreciate that. It's great to be with you. Thanks for the exposure for our program as well.
Well, Coach, you know, programs like yours do things the right way. They build the correct way. They've got the student first in all their athletic programs. And the best part is you've proven that you can win with that formula. And it doesn't hurt the university at all.
Yeah. It's something that we feel good about. I think you hit the nail on the head. Just doing it the right way. And, you know, when you walk away from a game or walk away from a season, or whatever you're doing within this football program, you know, you feel good with how it is and how it's running. And you know, you continually got to stay focused. You can never kind of let things slip, because once they start slipping, you know, it could snowball on you. So our staff does a wonderful job working together, you know, run a tight ship, do things right. And our guys, you know, take a lot of pride in doing that as well. And I think a lot of that stuff just relates to the wins that we get on the football field and the championships as well.
Well, you know, you said one thing right there that's very powerful, is that, you know, you do things the right way. Well, football, in most sports that people participate in, the athlete is sort of an example of what they're going to do in life. If they happen to slack off in football, they don't dot all the I's, they don't follow up on assignments, they are late to practice. Chances are they're going to do it in the classroom and then when they're out in life. And if they can manage what you're putting them through and understanding the fundamentals, because at football, at all levels, fundamentals rules out over talent every time, you're going to show up in the win column, and that's something they can take with them the rest of their lives.
Yeah, and you know, you're part of such a big group, you know, when you're on a football team. And even though you may not think your job's as important, all of a sudden, you know, there's examples, you know, especially after playing our first game of the year here, you know, one guy makes that mistake, and it really can bring down the whole unit or the team. And put you in a tough position. So everyone realizes the significance that they each have, whether it's on or off the field.
Coach, the one of the things we always bring out all the time is on a football team, you've got to have leaders. Some teams, it's one of the offensive linemen that takes over the reins because the quarterback wants to be the leader. He happens to be the quarterback, where the offensive lineman, or it's on the defensive side where he's screaming at the offensive line to beef it up. Who are those guys in your program that are sort of taking over the control of the team on the field?
Well, really, you know, it's our upperclassmen. You know, we have captains, just like any other team would have. But, you know, I think it's an upperclassmen thing more than that, because the captains can't control everything. We have 19 seniors this year and 20 juniors. And so there's a lot of upperclassmen that we put the pressure on to make sure that their leadership by example, their leadership vocally whenever it needs to be done, is done, and the rest of the guys understand, you know, the importance in that. So you're right, the leadership is huge, especially when times are tough or when you're in the big games. It's easy to have good leadership when you're rolling along through a game or a season. But I think you get in the playoffs, you get into a championship atmosphere. That's when the leaders are truly important.
Coach, we do a lot of examples. We deal with a lot of coaches across the board in all divisions, D1 all the way down to NIA, and one message comes across loudly. We have Dan Antonio here in the state of Michigan who's rebuilt Michigan State. They did very well this weekend, but his coaching style is a lot like yours, and we're picking on Michigan State for listeners here in the state on this side of the country who are familiar with Dan Antonio. He's calm. He doesn't curse at his athletes. He does get mad, but he builds up his athletes to understand why they're doing this. And in your program, it is so important because you do have a small staff to work with. You got a lot of volunteers involved, and if you come across the wrong way, you misrepresent the school and the Christian Foundation. And it's so big in your organization.
Yeah, exactly. We're a private Christian you know, liberal arts school, and so even just operating that way, I probably wouldn't last long here. But you know, it makes it enjoyable when you can work as a staff together, and then you know, to transfer that on or bring that, push that on to the players and help them see how great you know, when you work together like our staff does, how great it can be, and our players, just the chemistry within them is so great, because I think it's just a trickle-down effect from how our staff operates. And so it's real enjoyable each and every day to step on the field, and I think our guys, you know they're going to get pushed, like you said. Know we're, you know, we're going to have times where we're frustrated. I mean, that's part of the deal. And
absolutely.
Maybe get yelled at a little bit, but for the most part, it's us, and we get us working together, both coaches, players, to find that that common ground where we can be successful to our highest potential.
Well, that's a big part of it, Coach. There's a lot of kids who respond differently to certain tones and how things done. Some guys automatically have a work attitude when they show up in a football game. They're going to try as hard as they can, no matter what, and they're going to, regardless of who's leading the team or not, they're going to make sure and do their job right. And then there's the other guy who went out last night, the day before, even though the coach said no, he's a little tired, dragging his feet, and then he needs to have that emotional element in your program that you have. You have worked so extensively on the fundamentals. You watch your execution. You make very few mistakes. It seems like you can roll almost three deep if you wanted to on having kids execute the X's and O's beautifully. You do such a great job of outlining how things are supposed to be done. When you get back to the room, coach's room, and you look at the videotape, how often do you go, God, they did everything great. What do we need to improve on?
Very few, actually. I can't remember many times, you know, where you walk away, and I think the key is you're always trying to improve, and so you always find those mistakes, and that's kind of part of coaching, I think, is finding those mistakes, and you do build on the positives. And you know, this week we really started rough offensively, but I walked away from the game feeling comfortable and very good about
your
what
phone?
This team could be. And so you know, a lot of those things take place when you come back to the coach's office. You pop on the film. Our saying is, it's never as good as you think. It's never as bad as you think. And so, you know, we always wait to make sure we see what the film shows us.
Coach, thank you so much. We're going to ask if we give you a call in another month, probably after the Hastings College game. Would that be okay?
Yeah, it would be a real good game for us. Hastings is 2-0 right now and rolling well, and it would be a tough conference opponent for us here early in the season. Fortunately, we have them at home.
Yeah, that always makes things easier when your fans are on your side and things might be tough.
That's right. It helps out the momentum. And we have been fortunate enough to win 37 straight at home now over the last four seasons. So hopefully that streak continues through this year as well.
Absolutely. Coach Kalen DeBoer from University of Sioux Falls football. He's got a juggernaut program. I'm trying to think of another word besides dynasty, one of the easiest words misused in sports, but he definitely has it going on for many years in that program, and he probably has many more years left to just dominate this conference, this league. Thank you so much, Coach.
All right. Thank you, Bo.
You're welcome. We are off the air.